Institute of Public Relations strategizes on effective management of lobbying for decision making. Governor Ben Ayade inaugurates construction and fabrication facility to address skills acquisition concerns. Plus, over 500 women and youths across South-South geopolitical zone benefit from National Center for Women Development Empowerment Program. Details of these and more in just a moment. Good evening. Welcome to NTA News at 7. I am Maureen Leo Ajom. Now the news in full. They need to effectively manage and regulate the practice of lobbying as a specialized area of public relations for decision-making in Nigeria was on the front burner of discuss at the opening of a three-day workshop organized by the Nigerian Institute of Public Relations held in Calabar. Uda Etem was there for NTA News.
Lobbying is fast becoming a potent tool for advocacy, which is being used by many groups or individuals, especially when an issue of interest is undergoing a legislative process. The concept of lobbying as an information communication process is rarely discussed in the public relations body of knowledge. Hence, the hosting of a three-day workshop by the Nigerian Institute of Public Relations to give a better understanding of the practice from legal and public relations perspectives. Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, represented by the General Manager NTA Calabar, Mr. Samuel Olalude, is calling for a dynamic professional institution.
Public relations experts can play an important role in ensuring that managers are communicated and communicated accurately. You all have an understanding of what messages resonate and how to best pitch them.
We therefore recommend a full unit in the Department of Mass Communication that will take lobbying as a full program.
The words of the governor, and I agree with him, as part of a study in the tertiary institutions so that people graduate and come out to it.
Others speak.
Imperative of bringing to fore the issue of lobbying, and we felt it was time that we came together since we believe it is a public relations function.
The issue of lobbying, it enhances participation in the decision and policy making process.
Because we believe that lobbying can bring about the right change we need in Nigeria.
The workshop is expected to make participants to understand lobbying as an integral part of modern strategic communication required to drive participatory governance. In Calabar, Uduak Etam, NTA News.
Developing human capacity is one of the essential components of the industrialization agenda of the Cross River State Government, led by Governor Ben Ayade. The inauguration of a construction and fabrication facility to build entrepreneurs in West Africa, address skills acquisition concerns in the state, and promote job creation is the reason for this academy. Paul Ebel reports.
The Construction and Fabrication Academy of West Africa is to address the dearth of middle-level skilled manpower, especially in Cross River State, as experts from across the world have been engaged to impart knowledge on the trainees. The first batch of trainees, 500 in number, are grateful for the opportunity as pioneers of the academy, promising to make the state proud by contributing to the societal development after graduation.
This academy that you've established, Your Excellency, has promised to give us same. So we want to say thank you very much.
The state government is of the view that the feat will enable people to earn a living, as the governor provides 400 million naira as take-off grant for the academy.
The skill is key. The future has moved from intellectualism to action. Let your handwork feed you. It is the responsibility of government to provide a shoulder for our young people to lean on. And that's why we're setting up this construction and fabrication academy.
We are starting from, with 11 skills to be acquired. And those skills will be within the duration of 6 months.
The Fabrication Academy offers training in welding and fabrication technology,
masonry works, carpentry, modern roofing, air conditioning repairs and installation. Others include screeding and aluminium glazing, among others. In Calabar, Paul Abel, NGN News.
President Muhammadu Buhari's agenda of raising over 100 million Nigerians out of poverty is materializing, as over 500 women and youths from the south-south zone of the country have been trained and empowered to become self-reliant. This is coming from the National Center for Women Development, as the center records giant strides in the training, development and empowerment of women and youths with relevant skills, startup kits and seed grants. Correspondent reports.
The post-COVID training for innovation and empowerment in the South-South zone focuses on selected vocational and entrepreneurial skills, including cosmetology, sewing, shoemaking, hygiene products, poultry, and fishery. Beneficiaries got drilled in the skills for 2 weeks, but what may be most amazing to them is the quality of empowerment received.
I will show the world that this empowerment that I have today, I will use it.
The problem is that I will also teach other people so that they will also benefit the way I'm benefiting.
If they empower women like this, it will enable them to continue to vote for the party.
Stakeholders of the All Progressives Congress express confidence in the party with the gesture demonstrated.
So my advice is that they should get their business registered with the Corporate Affairs Commission, where they can also benefit from other federal government grants and loans.
So whenever a woman is empowered, you can take it to the bank. That means the household is empowered.
Prof, you can imagine this number of women, I think they are about 500 or thereabout, being self-employed. You can imagine the percentage of poverty that has been taken off the streets.
Director General, National Council for Women Development, Mary Ekpere Eta, says the program is the center's contribution to achieving President Buhari's agenda of bringing over 100 million Nigerians out of poverty while improving their livelihood.
So the pandemic came with a lot of came and left a lot of damaging effects in our economy. So the president deemed it necessary to ensure that women who are the most hit be brought back to their economic activities by training and empowering them, creating a base for them to bounce back to their economic activities.
She also charged beneficiaries of the program to make judicious use of the empowerment, pointing out that monitoring teams will conduct inspection of beneficiaries' advancement, and if any failure, defaulters will be sanctioned. One of the critical mandates of the National Center for Women Development is to train, develop, and economically empower Nigerian women and youths for national growth. In Calabar, Maureen Leo Ajom, NTA News.
The federal government is planning to provide 10-bed intensive care units in every state of the federation as part of strategies to provide critical response to COVID-19 pandemic in the country. Minister for Health Dr. Osagie Ehanire disclosed this while giving assurance that the focus on COVID-19 prevention and treatment would not wipe out the maintenance of normal routine vaccination. He said this in continuation of series of presidential briefings coordinated by communications team at the State House in Abuja. The meeting focused on health sector and plans for the smooth rollout of the COVID-19 vaccines received recently by the federal government. And to environment, climate change is expected to displace millions of people, and engineers are worried that man may be pushing the planet towards ecological collapse. This was at the 2021 World Engineering Day in Abuja. Adebola Brookslyn, Sunday Reports.
Onyechi Okafor may be doing her business legitimately, but she is one of those emitting the one quarter of global black carbon, which the United Nations says is the second largest contributor to climate change,
after carbon dioxide through log burning.
Firewood is not that easy because of the smoke that comes out of it. People always say that they like the firewood. It's the natural, the local taste that comes when you use firewood to cook, unlike gas.
Worried by this challenge and knowing that man cannot naturally be detached from his environment, Nigerian engineers joined their counterparts the world over towards ensuring they play their role in the achievement of the UN Sustainable Development Goals by ensuring a healthy planet.
As engineers, we know that the solution to make the planet healthier lies on us because we work for common good always.
If you keep adapting without mitigating, what you are doing is compounding the effects on the poor. Also, reducing carbon dioxide emissions will not halt climate change in the immediate. Engineers need to start sustainable adaptation now.
Director General of the NTA, Yakubu Ibn Mohammed, was recognized for his support and drive for Luku content.
The DG2, this will motivate him to do more. We want to address the issue of climate change too in NTA because we operate with generator all the time. But I'm happy, Lithium, we have started with our hobby vans. We are using inverter. We are trying to see how we can integrate it into solar technology and it will reduce costs. So thank you very much. We
are most the adaptation and mitigation proposed by the forum is hoped will help change the cooking culture of Onyechi Okafor and prevent greenhouse gases and the global warming from rising to 2 degrees Celsius. Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
You are watching news reaching you from the studio of NTA Calabar. You can watch this newscast on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/NTA Calabar. We'll take a break for now and the news continues shortly.
Everyday events occur, and as they occur, we bring them to you anywhere you are. News updates showing on your channel of choice, NTA Channel 9 Calabar, afford you opportunity to get it fresh, hot, and loaded. 3 minute newscast of headline story every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You can't afford to miss it. It is the news update on NTA Calabar, the station for the people.
Members of the public with any complaint concerning any of our programs should forward their complaints to the Nigerian Television Authority, Channel 9 Murtala Mohammed Aiwi Calabar, phone numbers 0906-198-3183, 0906-883-6550, email address ntacalabar@nta.gov.ng, or to the National Broadcasting Commission, NBC, plus 32 Parliamentary Housing Estate, second gate behind Zanzibar Hotel, Calabar. Telephone number 0818-445-9924. Email address nbccalabar@yahoo.com. Signed, Management of the National Broadcasting Commission.
Welcome back to the news. Abia State Governor Okezie Igbeazu says the ongoing efforts by the 9th National Assembly to pass the long-awaited petroleum industry bill is a step in the right direction towards giving host communities a sense of belonging. The governor stated this when he received a delegation of the National Assembly Joint Committee on Petroleum Industry Bill at the Government House, Umuahia. Kingsley Ononiwu has more.
Addressing the delegation led by the Chairman Senate Committee on Petroleum Upstream Sector, Senator Abat Abanbase, Governor Igbeazu Frank Adewe Amana, some oil companies operating in the state are denying the host communities of their entitlements, a situation he believes will be addressed when the Petroleum Industry Bill is eventually passed into law.
It's also shocking that despite the fact that they have received greater cooperation from the oil-bearing communities in other states, you will not notice one signboard of any company or any company in India. They don't live here, they don't pay taxes here. And I wonder what the benefit. They come trapped in coastal vans led by newly armed soldiers from Port Harcourt every day, and they leave.
The chairman, Senate Committee on Petroleum Upstream Sector, and the leader of the delegation, Senator Bassi, appealed to the host communities to shun all forms of hostilities in order to enable them benefit more from the passage of the Petroleum Industry Bill, which is pending at the National Assembly.
We believe, as the members of the National Assembly, that if we are able to address the hostilities in the host community, we can crash the cost of oil. More money will come into the Federation account, and the host community will be given a sense of belonging.
Members of the Joint National Assembly Committee on Petroleum Industry Bill are in the state for oversight working visit to some of the oil producing communities in Abia State as part of efforts to build consensus on Petroleum Industry Bill. In Umuahia, Kingsley Onanewu, NTA News.
Following the result of the 9th National Assembly to ensure the passage of a bill that will address the challenges in the petroleum sector for overall national economic growth, the Joint National Assembly Committee on Petroleum Industry Bill has received 15 memoranda from stakeholders in Akwa Ibom State. At a town hall meeting in Uyo, members of the host communities made a strong case for the involvement of all key industry players in the proposed bill. Clement Barikui tells us more.
Described as the longest bill on the floor of the National Assembly, having been first introduced 13 years ago, the Petroleum Industry Bill has suffered several setbacks due to some perceived lapses in the bill. Among the grey areas in the bill that should be addressed, as listed by representatives of the civil societies, host communities and the state government during the town hall meeting, include regulatory overlaps, licenses to international oil companies to flare gas, lack of provision for transition for fossil fuels to renewable energy, as well as no clear definition of what constitutes host community.
State governments are excluded from the process of appointing members into these various committees.
In order that it may not have a relationship with host communities, Mr. Chairman, tell me, who is a host community that this measure is going to affect?
Regrettably, some of the solutions we preferred did not touch the fundamental issues in the administration of the petroleum industry.
The role of NOSTRA, the role of NESREA, the roles of the state ministries of environment, and the role of the federal minister of environment continues to overlap.
The law should specifically emphasize the need to consistently evaluate and take remedial actions on impacts of gas flaring.
We appeal that the bill should cover other areas for development so that the benefit will spread to the host communities.
Chairman of the committee, Senator Sabo Naduku, said the observations were noted and will be considered in the proposed bill.
So it is paramount upon the PIB to make sure the necessary arrangement and adjustment are done so that the host community and the impacted community would be taken care of.
A total of 15 memoranda were presented to the Joint Committee for consideration in Uyo. Clement Barikui, NTA News.
National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, Niger State Command, has arrested two suspects in possession of 27 locally fabricated arms in Contagora, local government area of Niger State. Acting State Commander NDLEA Isaac Aloye said the arrests were made about 107 kilometers away from Kagara, where mass abduction of secondary students and women were carried out last month. Oriyomi Olagunju tells us more.
The Special Squad of the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, Niger State Command, during its stop and search exercise, clamped down on the two suspects, 35-year-old Danjuma Auta and 25-year-old Daniel Danraji, along Kotongora Zuru Road, few kilometers away from Kagara, the community where abduction of students and women took place last month. Parading the suspects, the NDLEA boss, Isaac Aloye, disclosed that 15 locally fabricated pistols and 12 locally made AK-47 rifles were concealed in a sack on a motorcycle suspected to be transported to Kebbi, a neighboring state, for finishing touches.
During our routine stop and search, we found these two guys with this sack and with these rifles. So it's our duty as law enforcement agency to arrest them. And once we arrest them, when we found them like that, we felt that, yes, these are people who are not supposed to be in the society. They are supposed to be locked up somewhere. So we picked them and we are transferring them now to the Nigerian Police Force.
The suspect, Danjuma Autar, revealed to NTA News that the arms belong to an association to protect themselves from bandits. He explained that the 15th pistol found on him, loaded with bullets, is for his personal use and was purchased in one of the local markets in their community.
Our association, called Zaman Lafiya Dole, sent me to purchase the arms.
Proliferation of arms in Nigeria, particularly in rural community, is assuming an alarming proportion, hence the need for concerted efforts to complement the government in winning the war against insecurity. Oriyomi Olagunju, NTA News.
And now to sports. Team Nigeria intensified training ahead of 2021 African Continental Track Cycling Championship. Tamara Diwe brings us details on sports update.
The federal government has thrown its weight behind the candidature of the president of the Nigeria Football Federation, Amaju Pinnick, at the upcoming FIFA Council elections in Morocco, March 12. Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Youth and Sports Development, Nebolisa Anako, highlights the benefits to Nigeria should Amaju Pinnick emerge victorious at the elections.
If the NFF president wins this position, it will not be a victory for the federal government and all Nigerians alone, but the African continent. It will be.
In cycling, 11 cyclists have commenced training at the Velodrome Package A of the Moshood Abiola National Stadium, Abuja, preparatory to this year's African Continental Championship Track Cycling, holding in Cairo, Egypt, March 10 to 14. The team, which comprises 3 males and 8 females, will participate in junior, under 23, and elite categories.
We have Destiny Onyewo, we have Deborah, Jessica, they are all new talent discovered, and by the grace of God, they will do Nigeria proud.
The contingent will depart Nigeria March 8. Meanwhile, boxing promoter Bob Arum says Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury have agreed to a world title unification fight, although date and venue are yet to be decided. The all-British bout between 32-year-old WBC champion Fury and 31-year-old Joshua, who holds the IBF, WBO and WBA titles, will see all four belts contested in a heavyweight fight for the first time. With sports updates, Tamara Ebiwe, NTA News.
And that report on sports concludes our bulletin for tonight. But before we go, a quick recap of our major stories. Nigerian Institute of Public Relations has strategized on effective management of lobbying for decision-making. The Cross River State Governor Ben Ayade has inaugurated the construction and fabrication facility targeted at addressing skills acquisition concerns in the state. You also heard in the news that the National Center for Women Development has empowered over 500 women in the South-South zone with skills and startup kits for self-reliance and national growth. That's it on the news. Many thanks for watching. Have a good night.